Bari students, in this session we are going to discuss about Cash's theorem and some theorems on Cash's theorem. What is Cash's sequence? What are the theorems related to this Cash's sequence? Suppose Cash's sequence is different from normal sequence. How can we define the sequence? Suppose sequence SN is converges to L. The sequence SN is converges to L. Then by definition, for epsilon is greater than 0, then it is M belongs to Z plus SZ modulus of SN minus L is less than epsilon for all N greater than or equal to M. This is a sequence, convergent sequence, but Cash's sequence. What is Cash's sequence? Suppose the sequence SN is said to be Cash's sequence if for every epsilon is greater than 0, the register P comma Q belongs to Z plus such that modulus of SP minus SQ is less than epsilon for all n greater than or equal to P comma Q, the register M belongs to Z plus such that modulus of SP minus SQ is less than epsilon for all P comma Q greater than or equal to M. So see the difference between normal sequence and this is Cash's sequence. The sequence SN is Cash's sequence for even epsilon is greater than 0, there exists some positive integer M such that modulus of SP minus SP is less than epsilon. So this is a definition of Cash's sequence. Let us see theorems related to these Cash's sequence. First one, theorem. Every convergent sequence is Cash's sequence. Every convergent sequence is Cash's sequence. How can we prove this theorem? First of all, let sequence SN is convergent sequence. Now we prove that sequence SN is Cash's sequence. So to prove that the sequence is Cash's sequence, we have to use convergent sequence definition. Since sequence SN is convergent. By definition we can write for epsilon is greater than 0, where it is M belongs to Z plus such that modulus of SN minus L is less than epsilon. Modulus of SN minus L is less than epsilon for all M greater than or equal to M. So for P comma Q greater than or equal to M, modulus of SP minus L is less than epsilon. Modulus of less than epsilon by 2, I am taking here epsilon by 2. This is also epsilon by 2. And modulus of SP minus L is less than epsilon by 2. So I am applying the same convergent sequence for P comma Q. Instead of N, I am taking P and Q. Now consider modulus of SP minus SQ that is equal to modulus of SP minus L plus L minus SQ, that is modulus of SP minus L less than or equal to plus modulus of SQ minus L. SP minus L is less than epsilon by 2 plus epsilon by 2, that is equal to epsilon. So we have shown that modulus of SP minus SQ is less than epsilon for all P comma Q greater than or equal to. Means as per the definition, the sequence SN is Cash's sequence. So every convergent sequence is Cash's sequence, right? See, let us see another theorem. Every Cash's sequence is bounded. Every Cash's sequence becomes maybe bounded. every cache sequence, cache sequence is bounded. See another theorem. Every cache sequence is bounded. In the previous theorem, we discussed about every convergent sequence is cache sequence. Now we will explain the theorem how to prove this every cache sequence is bounded. Suppose sequence SN is cache sequence. Cache is sequence. Now we prove that it is bounded. We prove that sequence SN is bounded. We prove that it is a bounded sequence. Since sequence SN is cache sequence, cache sequence, that implies by definition, how to write that? If it is a cache sequence, already we know that for epsilon is greater than 0, there exists m belongs to z plus z modulus of sp minus sq is less than epsilon for all p comma q greater than or equal to m. Instead of this, I am writing modulus of sp minus sm is also less than epsilon, that is sm minus epsilon is less than sp is less than sm plus epsilon. I am supposing let theta is equal to minimum of s1 comma s2 comma and so on sm minus 1 comma l, that is sm plus epsilon minus epsilon, and if it is equal to maximum of s1 comma s2 comma and so on sm minus 1 comma sm plus epsilon. That implies a1 is less than or equal to sp is less than or equal to k. That is, the sequence SN is bounded because k1 is lower bound and k2 is upper bound. So if any sequence has infimum and supremum means lower bound and upper bound, that's such sequence is said to be bounded. So clearly we have proved that every cache sequence is bounded. This implies sequence SN is bounded. So right. Students, now we see one more theorem related to this cache sequence. That is, every cache is sequence is convergent. Every cache sequence is convergent. In the previous theorem, we have proved that every convergent sequence is bounded. Every convergent sequence is cache sequence. Every cache sequence is bounded. Now, I am going to prove that every cache sequence is connected to the one of the three theorems. First one is, every convergent sequence is cache sequence. Every cache sequence is bounded. Similarly, every cache sequence is convergent. To prove that every cache sequence is convergent, first we show that it has a unique limit, because every cache sequence is bounded. Bounded means it has a unique limit, but we suppose that there are two limits. Finally, we will get the condition. From that, we say that it has a unique limit and bounded. Every bounded and has a unique limit, then we say that the sequence is convergent. So, like that, we can prove this theorem. Suppose sequence SN is cache sequence. Cache sequence. But previous theorem, by known theorem, that means previous theorem already we proved that every cache sequence is bounded. That means sequence SN is bounded. It is bounded. Bounded, now we show that it has a unique limit. We show that sequence SN has unique limit point. I'm going to prove that it has a unique limit point. But actually, we suppose that let L, L dash are two limit points, or two limit points of the sequence SN. Such that I'm supposing let epsilon is equal to taking the difference L minus L dash, which is greater than 0. epsilon is equal to either difference L minus L dash. Now, which is greater than mu? L minus L dash, the difference is positive. That means epsilon is greater than 0. Now, since sequence SN A is Cauchy sequence, whenever it is a Cauchy sequence, by definition, we can match by epsilon. Epsilon is greater than 0. The richest n belongs to Z plus, such that modulus of SP minus SQ is less than epsilon by 3 for all p comma q greater than or equal to m. So this is one relation, SP minus SQ less than epsilon by 3. Because of the sequence SN is a Cauchy sequence. By definition of Cauchy sequence, for epsilon is greater than 0, then it is m belongs to Z plus, such that modulus of SP minus SQ is less than epsilon for all p comma q greater than or equal to m. But already we assume that the sequence has two limits. What are the two limits? L comma M. That means there exist two values. That is, since we are supposing L comma L dash are two limit points of the sequence SN. If L comma L dash are two limit points of the sequence SN, then there exist p greater than equal to m and q greater than equal to m, such that modulus of sp minus l is less than epsilon by 3, modulus of sq minus l dash is less than epsilon by 3 for p comma q greater than or equal to m. Now consider modulus of l minus l dash. Modulus of l minus l dash, that is equal to modulus of l minus SP plus SP minus SQ plus SQ minus L dash. I am taking like this, adding and subtracting and adding. Sorry, subtracting and adding. Instead of in between L and L dash, I am taking some terms SP minus SP plus SP minus SQ plus SP. So directly I am going to split into three parts. That is, less than or equal to modulus of L minus SP plus modulus of SP minus SQ plus modulus of SQ minus L dash. Modulus of SP minus L is same as L minus SP. That value is what? Less than epsilon by 3. Plus SP minus SP is also less than epsilon by 3. Plus it is also epsilon by 3. Totally what is the value? Epsilon. Modulus of L minus L dash is less than epsilon, but it is contradiction because epsilon is equal to already we have taken L minus L dash, but modulus of L minus L dash we got by less than epsilon. This is absurd, means it is a contradiction. Therefore, L and L dash are not two limit points, only L is our limit point. That means the sequence has a unique limit point and it is bounded. By known theorem, if a sequence is bounded and it has a unique limit, then that sequence is said to be convergent. So clearly, the sequence is convergent. That means we conclude that every Cauchy sequence is convergent. So, students, now we see some problems using this on the sequences. By using the direct sequence, we will see some problems. By definition of sequence, show that SN is equal to 1 plus 1 by 2 factorial plus 1 by 3 factorial plus and so on plus 1 by n factorial is Cauchy sequence. Where to prove this is a Cauchy sequence. Cauchy sequence means SM, take any value, SM modulus of SM minus SN is less than epsilon for m greater than n, or SP minus SP is less than epsilon for p greater than q. So we prove that this is by using direct sequence, by method of by the definition of direct sequence, we prove that this is a Cauchy sequence. So this is a value of let SN is equal to 1 plus 1 by 2 factorial plus 1 by 3 factorial plus and so on plus 1 by n factorial. From this write the value of SN, but the condition is for m greater than n. M is greater than n, so that SN is equal to SN containing more terms than SN. So 1 plus 1 by 2 factorial plus 1 by 3 factorial plus and so on plus 1 by n factorial plus 1 by n plus 1 factorial plus and so on plus 1 by m factorial. Take the difference modulus of s m minus s n that is equal to up to 1 by n factor will be cancelled. That is equal to remaining 1 by n plus 1 factorial plus and so on plus 1 by m factorial. Okay, that is the value which is less than or equal to less than 1 by 2 power m. This is less than or equal to 1 by 2 power m plus 1 by 2 power 2 power m plus 1 2 power m plus 1 and so on plus and so on plus 1 by 2 power n plus a. I am comparing with these terms. So I am taking 1 by 2 power m plus remaining 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 square plus and so on 1 by 2 power m. So this can be written as it is a geometric progression. According to the geometric progression, what is the integral formula? What is the integral formula? A into 1 minus r power m by 1 minus r. Here r is equal to 1 by 2. 1 into 1 minus 1 by 2 whole power m minus 1 by 1 minus 1 by 2. This is less than 1 by 2 power m minus 1. Means it is less than epsilon. That means modulus of SP, sorry, SM minus SN is less than epsilon. So we have shown that modulus of SM minus SN is less than epsilon. We say that this is a Cauchy sequence. So always to verify the given sequence is Cauchy sequence or not, for a contrarian, verify first order SM and SN take the difference must be less than epsilon. Whenever this difference is less than epsilon, then only the sequence is Cauchy sequence. See another example, actually this is Cauchy sequence, and see another example, Pratik. That SN is equal to R m plus minus 1 whole power n by n is not a Cauchy sequence. You have to prove that it is not a Cauchy sequence. We have to show that n plus minus 1 whole power m by n is not a Cauchy sequence. Let I suppose SN is equal to n plus minus 1 whole power m by n. Yeah, this is SM is equal to calculate SN plus 1 is equal to n plus 1 plus minus 1 whole power n plus 1 by n plus 1. This is SN plus 1 and take a difference modulus of SN plus 1 minus SN that is equal to n plus 1 whole power n plus minus 1 whole power n plus 1 by n plus 1 minus n minus minus 1 whole power n by n. So actually here n and n will be cancelled. That is the remaining terms here. What are the remaining terms here having? That is equal to 1 plus minus 1 whole power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Minus plus you can add minus 1 whole power n by n. That is less than or equal to 1 plus 1 by n plus n plus 1 plus 1 by n. And which is less than 1 plus 2 by n. 1 plus 2 by n is not less than epsilon. Modulus of Sn plus 1 minus Sn is not Sn plus 1 minus Sn is not less than epsilon. Means it is not a Cauchy sequence. So, we have shown that modulus of Sn plus 1 minus Sn is not a Cauchy sequence. Why? Because their difference value is not less than the epsilon. Right. One more theorem is there. Weierstrass theorem. Weierstrass theorem. Weierstrass theorem. Their statement is every bounded sequence has convergent subsequence. Every bounded sequence has convergent subsequence. That is the statement of Weierstrass. Suppose, see a proof of this one. Suppose sequence SN is bounded sequence. If it is a bounded sequence, then I am taking some limit. Let L is the limit point of the same as Sn. It is a limit. So L is the limit point of the sequence Sn. That implies the sequence has a limit point L. There is this K sequence Sn to N Sn plus 1 of sequence Sn such that the sequence is converges to the sequence Sn plus 1 is converges to N. Very simple theorem. Every bounded sequence has convergence of sequence. Suppose sequence Sn is a bounded. Let L is a limit point on the sequence Sn. Then there is this, whenever there is a limit point, then there is a subsequence Sn plus 1 of sequence Sn such that the sequence subsequence Sn plus 1 is converges to N. This is the proof of the Weierstrass theorem, Baljan-Weierstrass theorem. Now we see one example where Sn is equal to, the sequence is Sn is equal to minus 1 whole power n, minus 1 whole power into 1 plus 1 by n. This is the sequence. So test whether the terms, how the terms will be here. S1 is equal to minus 1 whole power 1 into 1 plus 1 by 1. This is the first term. Second term is minus 1 whole square into 1 plus 1 by 2, comma. Next term is minus 1 whole cube into 1 plus 1 by 3, comma. Minus 1 whole cube into 4 into 1 plus 1 by 4, and so on. So these are the terms I am writing. I am separating. I am writing S1, S2, S3, S4 by taking n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. For now, simplify this. This is equal to 1 plus 1. 1 by 1, 1 plus 1, 2. And that is minus 2. Minus 1 whole square value 1. 1 plus 2, 1, that is 3 by 2. Minus 1 whole cube is minus. 3 plus 1, 4 by 3, minus 4 by 3. Next again, minus 1 whole power 4 plus. 5 plus 1, 4 plus 1, 4 plus 1 is 5 by 4, and so on. Here there are two subsequences. One is minus 2, minus 4, 4 by 3, and so on. And another subsequence is 3 by 2, 5 by 4, and so on. So these are the two subsequences. So, and these are the subsequences. And see, for this sequence, how many subsequences are there? There are two subsequences. Actually, by previous theorem, Baljan-Weierstrass theorem, every bounded sequence has convergent subsequence. Right? See, some other problems related to ratio test. What we discussed in the previous class, discuss the nature of the convergence, discuss about the convergence of some problems. First one is a power n, second one is b power n by 2 power n, third one is n by b power n, next one is 2 power 3n by b power 2n, where 0 is less than a is less than 1 and b greater than 1. So at this value, 0 is less than a is less than 1 and b greater than 1. So there are four sequences. We have to discuss the convergence of these four sequences by using ratio test. Let first one, you see that Sn is equal to a power n, Sn plus 1 is equal to a power n plus 1. So from this, Sn plus 1 by Sn is equal to a power n plus 1 by a power n. This can be written as a power n into a by a power n. Both will be cancelled. That is, limit n tends to infinity Sn plus 1 by Sn, that is equal to b half only a is a constant, we cannot apply limit. And also a value less than 1, that's why the sequence a power n is convergent. A power n is convergent. So we have taken Sn is equal to a power n, Sn plus 1 is equal to a power n plus 1, Sn plus 1 an is equal to a power n plus 1 an. That is, by simplifying, you will get a. By applying the limit, you will get a, but already a value given, that is less than 1. Whenever that limit value is less than 1, by ratio test, we can say that this is convergent. So, in the same way, you see the next problem, that is, we have to discuss about the convergence. Let Sn is equal to b power n by 2 power n, Sn plus 1 is equal to p power n plus 1 by 2 power n plus 1. By dividing Sn plus 1 by Sn, that is equal to b power n plus 1 by 2 power n plus 1 into this is 2 power n by b power n. Then b power n will be cancelled, 2 power n, 2 power n will be cancelled, finally we have b by 2, b greater than 1, b by 2 is less than 1. So that this is less than 1, and applying limit by taking limit according to the ratio test, limit n tends to be Sn plus 1 by Sn is equal to b by 2, b is greater than 1, b by 2 is less than 1. That should is also convergent. The sequence b power n by 2 power n is also convergent. Okay. See, next problem. We discuss about the next topic. Next topic is convergence of the sequence, whether it is convergent or not. Let Sn is equal to n by b power n. Sn plus 1 is equal to n plus 1 by b power n plus 1. Now take the ratio of Sn plus 1 and Sn, that is Sn plus 1 by Sn, that is equal to n plus 1 by b power n plus 1 into b power n by n. B power n and b power n will be cancelled, remaining 1 by b into n, this is n plus 1 by n, that is equal to 1 by b into, by cancelling 1 plus 1 by n. By applying limit on both sides, limit, that is limit n tends to infinity Sn plus 1 by Sn, that is equal to limit n tends to infinity 1 by b into 1 plus 1 by n. By applying the limit for the second term, limit of limit n tends to infinity 1 by n is equal to 0. So this is 0, finally we have 1 by b. This 1 plus 0, 1 into 1 by b, 1 by b, less than 1. Because b greater than 1, 1 by b is less than 1. Clearly, this sequence is also less than 1. And the required sequence, that is n by b power n, is convergent. Students, like that, you can practice the next one also. 2 power 3n by 2, 3 power 2n. Test whether that is convergence or not by using ratio test. Okay, maybe you get 2 by 3 is less than 1 or 3 by 2, whatever it may be, depending on the value, we can say that maybe you will get 8 by 9. For example, if we got 8 by 9 out of the limit value, that is less than 1. Here we know that 8 by 9 is less than 1. 8 by 9 is less than 1. Whenever that value is less than 1, according to the ratio test, the sequence is convergent. Okay, thank you, students.